Welcome back, everyone, to another walkthrough series, episode 11. In the previous episode, we started Krakatopia. We got through Palace of Fire, Royal Hall, and Chamber of Fire. Now, in this episode, we'll be doing the Throne Room of Fire, as we did at the end of episode 10. The guy over here talked to us, and he said we're going to be entering the Throne Room of Fire. So the first thing we have to do is we have to talk to Professor Winthrop. And my bad, guys, I went to the wrong area. All right. Hopefully you're all enjoying your beautiful Thursday night. Sorry for not uploading in 2 days. My bad, everyone. It's just been a little while since I've uploaded a video. I try to upload daily for you guys. I did not upload yesterday. Sorry about that. So hopefully you guys forgive me for that. And we are on our way to the Throne Room of Fire. Now, let's not try to get caught here. And guys, here is the Throne Room of Fire. Let's do this, guys. Alright, so we have to talk to the professor still. Serpent Staff. Right, and here is the professor, everyone. Let's see what he has to say.
There you are. I've got my notes now. Let's get to work tracking down the Order of the Fang, shall we? We'll most likely need the use of a serpent's staff, so I'll trust you to procure one for us. According to my notes, the Order of the Fang used magic to hide their location. Only by using a powerful artifact in this map room can we undo their spell. There! That slot must be where the serpent staff would go. And I remember Prince Manunirini swung it at my head when the Tuts attacked. I'd rather not have a repeat of that. Could you go down the hall and battle Prince Manunirini for the Serpent Staff? We must set things right.
All right, everyone. So, the next quest says we need to defeat Manunirini and collect the Serpent Staff. All right, guys, we're going to collect this wooden chest, by the way. 18 gold. So, on our way to Prince Manunirini. Let's defeat him. Alright, looks like we're coming up on something here. And let's read what this Book of Secrets says.
None shall pass through the door unless all the braziers burn with red flames.
So none shall pass through the doors unless the braziers burn with red flames, guys. So if you're in the exact same location I am, these are the braziers. And basically what you want to do is you want to turn these all to red as an example. Please turn them like that, all four of them, if you didn't understand what it meant. Right, and the great door has opened. There he is, everyone.
You are in the presence of royalty. Bow or suffer my wrath.
All right, so it is fire and a death. So we do have stuns, which we do have heals as well. And that is looks like a pretty good death for me. So first off, guys, like we always do, we're going to knock out the death. All right. What we're going to do is we are actually going to Volcanic Shield. Right, he's doing fairy, death fairy. Alright, what we're gonna do is we're gonna ice trap the minion. Right, he's using fire bats. 89 damage on us. Right, he's hitting us as well with fire. And we are going to ice trap him. Hopefully do a decent amount of damage on him. Hopefully, maybe can kill him next. We should be able to kill him next round, team. Alright, that sucks. I don't think that's gonna kill him. Alright, we're gonna try. Oh, come on. No, not a... Okay, this ain't gonna kill him. Darn, he's ruining our plans! Alright, we still did a nice 287 damage on him. Now... let's finish him up with a snow server. Alright, what's he doing? He is fizzling! Now let's see what he's doing. Okay, I thought he was gonna get some health back. I was about to get a little nervous there. Okay, that hurt a little bit more than I thought. But let's finish it up. Minion is down. Goodbye, minion. Alright. Team, we're also gonna... we can't stun him. So we're gonna heal. Because he is off fire, and then next we'll do Volcanic Shield. Now, perfect timing by me. Good thing we did heal. Because that is going to hurt severely bad. Good call by me. Alright. We're gonna Volcanic Shield. Keep damage away from us. And if I do have an enchant in here, I will try to finish it up. We need a heal to show, so hold on. Alright, what we're gonna do is just in case. Okay, I was expecting maybe an ice shield. That kinda didn't go as planned. But we still got damage on him. Alright, guys. Can't stun. Now we may hit. As well as he's hitting as well, but he fizzled. And our turn to hit. 434 damage. He should be done. And GG for that, everyone. And he used Sunbird, but we are fine, team. We do have a shield on. And GG. Goodbye. Alright, so the goal is complete. We also got some shoes for death and some balance hats. Some balance hat. Alright, what do we got over here? Some parchment. That'll come in handy. Sometime. Wooden chest. Alright. Back to Professor Winthrop. Now, I'm not going to go for the health, because as the looks here, we will level up, team. But if it's right near us, I will try not to get caught by those death minions. Like, let's stalk the wall. We don't want to get, like, grabbed by those minions. And, we are about there. As we head into the map room. And here he is.
Good work. Now to use the staff. We'll soon figure out the Order's secret location. It's no use. The staff isn't working. What could I have done wrong?
Professor Winthrop stares at his notes in frustration, then looks up suddenly with a bright gleam in his eye.
That's it! In ancient times, the Eye of Croc was placed here in this room, but Croc and Common recently took it in a show of power. You must go further into Croc and Common's lair, defeat him, and take back the Eye of Croc. Then we can find the Order of the Fang at last.
Alright everyone, so we have to defeat the Croc and Common and collect the Eye of the Croc in the Throne Room of Fire. Now, if you didn't see it, if you were trying to listen to the words there of what he said, we are officially level 14 team. Really excited that we are leveling quite fast now. So let's keep it going. We will be doing Grizzleheim and Wisteria at level 20. We might stop and continue with another episode with Grizzleheim. I don't know what episode it'll be. Probably episode 18, maybe, somewhere around there. However far we get into Krakatopia. But once we reach level 20, I believe we get the first quest to Grizzleheim. And we will be doing the first part of Grizzleheim. So just wanted to tell you guys that. Because I do like to do the side worlds as well. They are fun. And I just really enjoy them. Alright guys, so now we have another puzzle here. Let's see what the puzzle is.
Where the two suns shine, the way will be clear. But not if there is any moon shining.
Alright, so where the two suns shines, the way will be clear, but not if there is any moon shining. So basically what that means, if you don't understand again what it means, is basically you want the two moons to not be shining. As you can see these colors right here, you don't want these shining because basically that will not unlock the door. So basically you want these two sunshines to shine. Alright, so here is the sun. And guys, the great door has opened. Alright, continuing here. We are about there, team. Hopefully everyone's having a wonderful day. Or wherever you live, hopefully you're having a wonderful time. Right. Do not want to make sure we get caught. Getting caught is no fun. Let me tell you that. Alright, there he is, guys. Now, I don't like to use treasure cards, but we are going to look what we got in here. What do I still got for ice? Do I have any more? No, okay. But, let's hop right into it, team. Hopefully we don't get a minion right on the first. Yes. Alright. We can't. Well, I do want to keep stunned, okay? The only reason why I want to keep stunned is for the other minion that's going to be joining here. Alright, we're going to start an ice trap. Sorry if you heard that. That is just a notification on something. Right. What we're going to do is we're going to volcanic shield. Now, he is at a high amount of health. But we're fine. We're going to volcanic shield. Now, I do love Krakatopia. A lot of fire bosses. You know, it's not, like, super hard if you're ice, but it can be tricky. This place can be tricky, soloing, but we should be fine. And every single time, we always get some kind of minus 25 on us, which kind of makes me a little irritated, just because it drops our attack, like, super, super, super hard. Okay, see, that would have been probably, like, almost 400. That would have probably been 400. But dropped our attack quite hard. What we're gonna do again is we do have heals, so we shouldn't be worried about, we shouldn't need to worry too much. Good thing about ice is we do get a lot of health. So that is one thing I do enjoy about ice, is we shouldn't need to worry about our death or our health too much. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna freeze the minion over there. and sadly, again. Oh, okay. I was about to get, like, a little bit worried, because I thought we were gonna, like, fizzle. Oh, wait. Oh, we didn't. What? Oh, no. Okay. New thing, everyone. I didn't know. I did not know about this. I did not know. You can't stun the minions. I did not know about that. So what we're going to do, I'm only worried about these attacks going to be hitting. Okay. Not too worried, but the minion is going to attack, which is going to do, hopefully it's not Sunbird. Ouch. No. Struggle. Crap. We are in a little bit of danger now. The stuns. I mean, not these stuns, but those hits that keep hammering us. Alright, he fizzled. We are, thank godly, fine. So let's heal back up here. And let's try this again. Without trying to get so hurt. Alright, what we're going to do is we're actually going to give Volcanic Shield. Alright, fire fizzles a lot, so, you know, I'm kind of excited. Trying to keep alive here. Alright. Still waiting on a... We're going to chip away the minion's health. And I probably should have healed. But that was my fault. I should have healed. Let me explain why. Because I have a feeling that something powerful is going to hit us next. I'm not sure what, but something's going to hit us and it's going to hurt really bad. So this can be a struggle if you guys are soloing. That's one thing now that I just learned. Oh, no. Okay. Still a little bit worried because if that's Sunbird. Okay. We are fine again. The ice struggle, everyone. The ice struggle. Okay. Let's finish up the boss. Now, I'm kind of thinking that we might have made a mistake, but I don't got any heals up. So, this is kind of nerve-wracking. Oh, no. Okay. Yikes. That spell is dangerous. Alright, please kill the minion, please. I mean, not minion, please kill the boss. Oh, wow, that just wrecked. Alright. And now to put a little pressure off us now. Shouldn't need to be as pressured now. Now that the boss is out of the way. Excuse me. And I think we're almost out of fairies, if I believe correctly. We're running through fairies forever. Alright, I need to like find more heals though. We're at 11 cards. Alright. And I think I did a smart decision here. Yep, okay. Okay, I kind of have a plan. Okay, we have a pony at least. Or a unicorn. Okay, once again, he's trying to weakness us, but I see that they always weakness, so we're gonna keep doing the same thing. Alright, what we're gonna actually do is we're gonna heal with the unicorn, and then what we're gonna do. Okay, he fizzled, which is kind of even good. Because now our petaheal. Thank you for that shadow, even though that took pips. Alright, we are fine now. Alright. We're in a volcanic shield. Alright, okay, we're fine. We're fine, guys. We're fine. Even though it takes longer, and let me tell you this, everyone. Soloing with an ice wizard can be really a struggle. So, I do want to put that out there. Please be careful with soloing ice. It can be quite hard. As I'm struggling at the moment. But this is not like episode 10 when we had all the internet connection problems and just, that was some terrible times. You know, we're doing really decent, so I'm quite excited that we're not doing so bad. And guys, if we don't fizzle, it is GG. Jinx myself, right? Let's do it again. Alright, I was like, oh no, please don't shield me. Oh my god. What is going on? Is it gonna make like a comeback or something? I'm kinda getting scared now, guys, because it feels like it's gonna make a comeback on me, and I'm like, gonna get wrecked. Alright. Finally, no fizzle. GG team. And ba bam, 433. Alright, and let's see what we got over here. Pink dandelion, tiny fish, some sandals of energy, and green grapes. And guys, we also got an inferno cat. Yes, guys, we have a fire cat. If you don't know what it looks like, I'll show you when it hatches. When it comes out in 11, well, I'm not going to show you in this episode, but I'll show you probably in the next episode. So episode 12, you guys will be able to see what it is. If you do not know what it is, I can probably explain it as well. Basically, it's just a fire cat. So if you didn't know what it was, that is what it is. But I'll also show you it in the next episode if you don't know what it is. If I believe correctly, you can also buy it in the pet pavilion. If you don't know what this is, guys, I should have explained it in the Wizard City place, but basically, you open it, and you have to spend 50 crowns, and you can get some kind of crown gear, or any kind of good gear, usually. It depends on what, you know, what King's Isle gives you, but it's worth it. At kind of a low level, you can get a chance of getting really good crowns gear, so go for it if you really want to, but I will not, because at the moment, I'm poor still, guys. And next Monday is the giveaway winners, if you didn't know about that. I'll be getting crowns tomorrow, for you guys, and, yes, let's not talk about the giveaway, this is more about the walkthrough. Here he is, guys, Professor Winthrop.
Splendid! We have the Eye of Croc. Since you defeated Croc and Common and Prince Manunarini, you deserve the honor of discovering the Order of the Fang. Go on. Take the Eye of Croc and the Serpent's Staff and place them in the slots on the platform. Then, repeat the ancient words I taught you.
Excuse me. Use the map room platform. So this is the platform.
You do as the professor says and shout the ancient words Alka-Shirah Kazam.
Alka-Shirah. I can't even say that. Flashes,
and with a crackle, the map reveals the secret meeting place of the Order of the Fang.
Oh no.
You've done it. The secret location of the Order of the Fang is revealed.
Hallelujah.
Never would have thought to look there. It's on another island. I need to gather one or two other things here. Meet me back in the Altar of Kings. We can continue from there.
All right, guys. So basically what just happened is we finally found the location of the Order of the Fang, and now we are getting into some interesting stuff in this walkthrough. So now we gotta go back to talk to Professor in the Altar of the Kings, and we're gonna take our little secret way to the Oasis. And let's go to the Altar of the Kings, see what the Professor gathered up while we were gone. and he said he was going to grab a couple things. So let's see what he has in plan to find or to get the Order of the Fang. Here he is, guys.
Excellent. We finally know where the Order of the Fang is. Now we can find them, get the Crocanomicon, and keep it from falling into evil hands. Now that we know where to find the Order of the Fang, we'll need permission to explore there. Go speak with Sergeant Major Talbot by the lake outside. Tell him we may have found a way to set things right again.
Alright guys, so we also got a furniture. It's the fire statue. I was going to say something, but I can't remember anymore. Alright, is there anything I gotta talk to Sergeant Major Talbot? Oh yeah, one thing, guys. Into the Altar of Kings, where the bug is. I never showed you that when I should have. I should have also showed you in the last episode. Let me show you where the bug is in this episode as well. The bug is, you can probably already see it as they're like going to the Chamber of Fire. Right here it is, everyone. Right here is the bug in the Altar of the Kings. In the last episode, I did show you where the bugs are in the Oasis. Alright, here he is, guys.
What ho! The Order of the Fang may have the secret to defeating the Tuts, eh? And it's an old book? Indeed. We must ensure that book doesn't fall into the wrong hands, then. Their inner lair must be explored at once. There is no time to lose. We set up ferries to Crocus Sphinx before the Crocs attacked. Good thing, too. I barely have time to think. The boat's there in front of me. Take it across to the island. I hope you find this lair where the Order of the Fang hides out. We could use some good news.
Alright guys, so we have to go to the Order of the Fang and Crocus Sphinx. And then we're going to the Balance School. The Balance School. So here's the boat to Crocus Sphinx. Let's take it. Now we're not going to watch the little ride. You know, I could play like Jeopardy music. Okay, I'm just kidding. We're going to skip the ride. Alright, before we get into anything, there's two things I want to show you. Over here is Niles. He is the balance tree. Really good thing I need to get at 25. If you do not know, if you're, I don't know, life, myth, death, fire, you know, all the six schools besides balance. You can go in here and also get recipe shops if you really want to, you know. You can craft them. You have to be balance school only. but you can craft them. And then also you can train them as well right here. Elemental Trap, Spirit Trap, Elemental Blade, and Spirit Blade. Now, I strongly suggest for the six schools, please get the Elemental or Spirit Blade. This is your decision if you want to get these, but they are also handy as well, so you may want to get them as well. But when we get 25, I'll definitely be getting those, which I'll be showing you guys in the other walkthrough. The second thing I wanted to show you is the bugs for Crocus Sphinx. Is if you go over here, up here, and look at that bug. He's just sitting there like, hey, what's up, guys? And I'm sitting here. Okay, right here he is, guys. Really kind of hidden, to be honest. I mean, I don't think it's, you know, showing right. Yeah, it's just not showing. So you have to actually look around in this area, but I showed it in this walkthrough. So if you guys want to go get it, you can go get it. It's really easy to get. All right, on to the Order of the Fang in the Balance School. I'm going to see Kevin Legend's teacher. Woo! Okay. Right. So we have to talk to all. Oh my god. All the Hazred or something like that.
Greetings. Welcome, stranger. I am Professor Alzred.
Alzred.
If you seek the Order of the Fang, you have found it. What brings you here?
You tell Professor Alhazred about your search for Malastare.
I have seen no Malastare, but I know why he sought us. Long ago, we wrote the Crocanomicon. With the power of life and death, he could spell disaster in the wrong hands. Before I say more, you must earn the Order's trust. Please go to the Croco Sphinx. Seek out Shalik the Wise and heed his words.
All right. So, order at last. We have to talk to Shalik the Wise, everyone. In Entrance Hall. and onto the Great Sphinx. Alright, guys. If you don't notice, we are almost level 15, everyone.
Greetings, wizard. So, the professor wants to test you. We are the ones being tested. We put the Tuts to sleep, but now our work is undone. They will try to enslave everyone. We must reunite the Order of the Fang. We have strong allies in the Manders, but they are struggling. Earn our trust by helping us. While Alhazred and I remained awake during the Great Sleep, other members of the Order of the Fang did not. If you are sincerely here to help, now is the time to seek them out. When I last saw General Kaba, our esteemed military leader was holding back the Tuts so we could cast the sleep. I only hope he has not suffered for his bravery. Go find the Mander Rami in the Hall of Champions. Rami can help you find Kaba.
Alright, everyone, so before we actually hop into Hall of Champions, over here that we are now level 15. Now, I just want to give this really quickly for I don't got to do it in the next episode. Right here.
I'm Simeon. Come and see me when you get a chance. I have news for you about housing. I'm in Ravenwood, near the boys' dormitory.
Right. So basically what he means is at level 15, you can get your first house. You can buy whatever house you want. If you want to go buy, like, for example, I'm trying to think of one of the houses. I can't even remember. The Oasis Camp, you can get at level 15. You can go buy those houses. The Marleybone, the Mushu houses, you can go buy those at level 15. So now you can get a house for a decent amount of price. I think it's 15,000 for the cheapest one in Wizard City in the shopping district. Alright, guys, we need to go talk to Rami in Hall of the Champions. And here he is, everybody, Rami.
I hope you've come to help, young wizard, because this place is swimming with Tuts. You are not the only one looking for General Kaba. The Tuts are looking for the Order of the Fang, and I fear we may be detected. We must slow them down before they find the General. Surely a powerful wizard like yourself can take out their minion, the Sphinx Sakwi.
Alright, everyone. This will actually wrap up episode 11. I believe we've been going for about 30 minutes, somewhere around there. But hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode. Most of this episode was thrown Room of Fire, and we also got to another island, Crux Phoenix. And guys, thank you for watching. Please subscribe, comment, like, and share. Thank you, everyone. And as of always, guys, I will see you in the next video. Goodbye, guys.